Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel.
And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
So today's video is going to be my first SAS haul, and I also have a few things from Victoria's Secret Pink to show you guys. So if you're interested in seeing what I picked up, then just keep watching. I do want to start off by saying, yes, I'm wearing my glasses. I'm so sorry for the glare. I really tried to set it up all cute and be in front of my bed with all my Christmas lights, but for that I'd have to use my ring light, and then you can really see like a ring light in my glasses. But I got Just Dance for my Nintendo Switch for Christmas, and I was playing it yesterday and stabbed myself in the eye with my fingernail, so I'm not allowed to wear contacts for a few days. So, lesson learned, Victoria, you don't need to go that hard on Just Dance. But anyways, I'll be wearing glasses for the next few days, so I'm sorry about the glare and everything, but it's really for the best to keep my eyes healthy. So anyways, I have a few bags to show you guys. I went to two different stores today, and today is December 28th. It is Monday. I wanted to wait until Monday to go because I didn't want to go out in all of the after Christmas craziness that was going to be Saturday and Sunday. So I waited until Monday and hoped that less people would be there, and there were a lot less people. So I'm actually going to put up some pictures on the screen for you guys from the first and second store that I went to. So the first store that I went to is a White Barn / Bath and Body Works store. So they had the combination store, and basically they had a lot of stuff, but they didn't have a lot of 75% off, and they didn't have a lot of like crazy cool finds. They had barely any candles. They had no sale candles. I mean, they had like the 50% off ones, but I don't really count that. And they had regular candles, but they didn't have any of the new cool ones that I was looking to smell. So they had some 50% off regular fragrances like Pink Cashmere and Pearberry and Country Apple. And those fragrances, really, you can wait because they'll go 75% off, like pretty much guaranteed. Those scents will go 75% off. And I think they also had blackberries and basil. And then they had some 75% off fall stuff. They had the Sugar Cherry Crisp. They had Kaleidoscope. A few things on the front of that display. I think they had Frosted Cranberry, Winterberry Wonder, A Thousand Christmas Wishes, the Papaya Paradise Cove, and the Pink Coconut Calypso, which I've had the Papaya Paradise Cove. I actually liked it a lot, but I really was not going for body care this time around for semi-annual sale because I already have so much. They had the $4.95 section, Papaya Guava Sunset, Agave Papaya Sunset. I just mixed two different ones. Hibiscus Guava Fresca. They had that whole summer line from this past summer, the Fresh Coconut Colada, Rosé Champagne, Lemon Drop Martini, and they had all of the Christmas scents also for $4.95, which those will probably also make it to 75% off by the end of this sale. So I'm definitely gonna check back with my stores near the end of the semi-annual sale. They had True Blue Spa for 50% off. Again, I was not going for body care, so I really didn't look at this stuff. I know True Blue Spa is good. They had Coco Shea. They had Bonfire Bash in the 50% off table, which I thought was weird. That should have definitely been in the 75% off table, and it will probably make it there. They had a bunch of shimmer sprays on 50% off. They had some moisturizing body washes, Golden Sunflower, Magic in the Air, some of the aromatherapy stuff. Most of aromatherapy was only 50% off, except for that that new aromatherapy spa line that they came out with, that was 75% off. They had some minis that were 75% off. And then they had a huge section of 75% off soaps from last summer. I had tried most of these. I think I had all of these already before. So I picked up a few of those. They had 375 soap, which I didn't think was a really good deal. They had 50% off soaps, which also I did not think was really a good deal, just because I knew they'd have 75% off soap. So those will probably make it to 75% off anyways. And then I went to my other store, which is an outlet store in my mall. And that store had a lot better selection, a lot more stuff, but again, not a lot of 75% off, almost no candles, no 75% off candles, which is to be expected because I waited until the third day to go, but I still thought there would be more. But anyways, they had all of the fall stuff 75% off. They had the Sugar Cherry Crisp Marshmallow Pumpkin Latte, Sparkling Plum Prosecco, Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin, White Pumpkin and Chai. They had Champagne Apple and Honey, and what was the lavender one? Lavender and Bloom. They had that collection. Again, for 75% off, they had the stuff that came out for Body Care Day, Secret Wonderland. They had a bunch of champagne toast left over from the spring. They had some Black Cherry Merlot and Little Black Party Dress, Coconut Blossom, Papaya Paradise Cove. And they had a bunch of the shimmer sprays from last Christmas. They had the Vanilla Bee Noel and Winter Candy Apple shimmer sprays, really surprising. They also had the Winterberry Wonder and Snowflakes and Cashmere from last year's line, which I was very tempted, but again, I was like, Victoria, you don't need body care, so I didn't pick that up. They had a bunch of 50% off body care, which I figure it'll probably make it to 75% off, but they had Japanese Cherry Blossom, Oahu Coconut Sunset, some Sunset Glow, and then again, they had 75% off minis. They had a lot more of minis at this store, but still not a great selection of minis. But they did have some summer stuff and some winter stuff, so that was nice. And then they had 350 hand soaps, which I was definitely down for. They had all of the fall stuff, 350, and all of the winter hand soaps were 350. And then they had all the wallflower refills, also 350. And I want to say they had some wallflower plugs that were 50% off. They also had a few like candle holders, accessories, and those kind of things 50% off and 75% off. I just wasn't looking for any of that stuff. And what really surprised me, actually, I got a picture of it, but there's a lot of people in this picture, so I'm not going to show you guys, but I did see that they had some snowy citrus swirl left over from last winter at this store. Really weird. But I had seen snowy citrus swirl at the store like a month ago, and so I figured they would have that and a few other things, but they really only had that, which was odd. I almost picked it up, but I smelled it and it's really kind of not my thing. Orange scents aren't really my thing. So anyways, that's everything that I saw at my store. I went in with a list. I only wanted to get hand creams, soaps, maybe some more pocket backs. I really wanted a lip scrub, some travel size minis because I was not allowing myself to get body care. And then my mom wanted some wallflower refills. So I'm going to show you what I got at the first store first. So this haul is definitely a little bit smaller. Again, they did not have a great selection of stuff. They didn't really have a lot of stuff on sale, but I got what I could. So I did get two of the 75% off soaps. I got fresh lemonade, which we used last summer, and watermelon lemonade. So these 75% off came to $1.87. And then I got this hand soap on 50% off, Toasted Vanilla Chai, which this is my favorite scent of all time in hand soap form. And this was only 50% off, so it was $3.75. Still not bad, but yeah, those are the only hand soaps I got. And then I got Hot Cocoa and Cream Shower Gel at 50% off. So this, oh, I'm sorry, this was 75% off. So this was $1.62. Really good deal, I think, in my opinion. And I wanted to try Hot Cocoa and Cream, but I didn't want to pay full price for this tiny little mini thing, so glad I got it on sale. I got a Snowy Peach Berry hand cream for 75% off. I didn't really want to get too many winter scents for hand creams because I want these to last me until summer SAS. So this one was $1.62, very good price. And honestly, Snowy Peach Berry, I didn't really give it much thought when it first came out, but it smells pretty good. And I feel like this would be a good one for like spring and summer because it's not necessarily anything to do with the winter time. It just smells very, very berry-y to me and very springy floral. So honestly, I don't get anything Christmassy about this. I don't know how they thought this was a Christmas fragrance, but yeah, this one will be good for spring and summer. And then the last thing that I got is the Winter Berry lip gloss, and I kind of had wanted these lip glosses for a minute. I just knew I was not willing to pay the full price, and the full price on these are $8.50. yeah, I'm not doing that. So this was $2.12. I think that's not that bad, $2 for a lip gloss. And I wanted one of the ones that was like an actual color, so this is like an actual color down here instead of just being like silver glitter like all the other ones are, so that I can actually feel like I'm getting some color out of this when I'm putting it on my lips. So Total for the first store, I spent about $13 before tax, so that's pretty good to me because typically two of these soaps at full price would have been $14. So pretty good for the first store. And the second store, I have two bags because I'm going to show you what my mom got first, just because I feel like it's, I don't know, I like showing you guys what my mom gets too, just because it's different scent palettes and she gets different things than I do. So she got some hand sanitizers. There was not a lot to choose from at either one of the stores on hand sanitizer. Not a lot of variety is what I mean. They had a lot of hand sanitizer, but not a lot of variety in scents. So she got 3 in Champagne Toast. We love this scent. I know she loves it and I love it too, so she just got 3 of these. I really like the cute little packaging on here with the kind of little champagne bursting confetti. So cute. And then the other two she got are Fiji White Sands, which is, this is just like a tropical scent. Really cute packaging too, nice and I would say like unisex, like you could give this to your man and he wouldn't be mad at you. And then Cactus Blossom, which I think she's not gonna like because this is kind of florally. So she'll probably end up giving this away to somebody, but we'll see. And then she got a few wallflower refills because she actually started using my wallflower plugin. I had not been using it because it either chokes me out in my room or it chokes them out being in the living room, but she started using it in kind of like the garage area slash our downstairs bathroom, and that's actually been really nice and like refreshing. And then it also has a light on my plug-in, so that way you can see at night when you go to the bathroom. So it's actually been pretty good working out. She's using my marshmallow fireside right now. I have like a peppermint brownie left, and then she bought 2 more. So she brought she bought autumn for the first one. And this was $3.50? Yes, okay. These were $3.50. Autumn is Gala Apple, Juicy Fig, and Eucalyptus Leaf. Just kind of like a fresh apple scent. And then she got Frosted Forest. It's Frosted Juniper, Iced Eucalyptus, and Evergreen Branches. Just kind of like a fresh scent. I told her, like, you don't really want to get something like foodie, like cookies or anything for the bathroom, because that's going to be like a weird scent whenever, you know, people go to the bathroom and then you're trying to get that scent out of there and you have like a cookie scent going. It's just not going to work. So I told her to try and get some like fresh scents. So those are the two that she picked up. And now on to my order. So I got a lot, and honestly this like really hurt walking around the mall with this because look, I got like bruises on my arms from where I had the bag on my arm walking around the mall, so would not recommend doing that. So this store I kind of went crazy on the soaps and I got a lot. So I got 2, 4, 6, 7 soaps, bringing my total of soaps from SAS to 10. So I think we're good on soaps for a minute, but I try to get a good variety so we could use it kind of in the summer, spring, and fall of next year. So yeah, let's just get started. The first one I got is Toasted Vanilla Chai, and these were all $3.50. They did not have any 75% off soaps at this store. These were all $3.50. So Toasted Vanilla Chai, again, my favorite scent. I got this one in the the foaming hand soap in like the fall packaging. So I figured I could use this for next fall. So that one will be really good. I got a raspberry tangerine. Isn't this packaging just beautiful? I thought this would be so gorgeous. This one smells honestly so good. This will be a really good one for spring and summer, and the packaging is just darling. The next one I got is All About Fall Y'all Cozy Vanilla Cream. I love the little pumpkin on here. I wanted this hand soap when it first came out and I just didn't end up getting it. So now I have it, and I feel like I could use this vanilla scent any time of year, but also I can use it for the fall for the cute little pumpkin on it. And the next one I got is Purely Clean Kitchen Mandarin. I had been looking at this collection for a while. I love the packaging on this and how simple it is. And I figure Kitchen Mandarin we can really use anywhere. And oh yeah, that's gonna be a good one for spring or summer. So that's a really nice scent. I got Boardwalk Vanilla Cone. I love this packaging on here. And it's like pinky magenta. I don't know, but I know I like this scent. We had a soap in this last year. It's just a nice, sweet, marshmallowy scent, so that's a good one. And then we got Love Ya a Latte Whipped Espresso. We used this in our downstairs bathroom this fall, so I know that I like it. And this is also a good one to use just kind of whenever. I figure I might put this out in like February for Valentine's Day, and it'd be really cute. And then I got I'll Be There Coconut Lime Verbena. And I figured this one will also be really good for spring slash summer. So I feel like I'm definitely stocked up until the next SAS, maybe even past that. We'll see. Me and my brother have been getting through soaps like maybe one every 2 months. So it takes us quite a while to use them up. So I'll probably be good for the next 5 to 10 months. So yeah. The next things that I got are body care. So I kind of dropped the ball on that. But I got 2 hand creams, which I really needed. I kind of thought that I would need like 6 hand creams because I've been using one every month for the past, I don't know, since the pandemic started because my hands have been so dry. So I've only bought 3 so far. So I definitely will go back to semi-annual sale and try to find some more. But the first one I got is Mary Cookie. I actually just finished one of these up in December. So I know I really love it. I'll have to wait a bit to use this because I'm kind of sick of it from when I was using it earlier, but I know that I really like this scent. And then I got Warm Vanilla Sugar. This was the last one in the bin of 75% off. So that was a really good find. I got a pumpkin cupcake car fragrance refill. I did not mean to get this. It was in the pile with the Warm Vanilla Sugar refills. So I thought I was getting that, but that's okay. I liked pumpkin cupcake when I used it in the car fragrance this year, so I'll just use it again next fall. So now I have it, and I believe this was 75% off, right? It was only 50% off, so it was $2, but still, I guess that's a good deal. I don't know. I'm like, I feel stupid that I just like picked that up and didn't even look at it. But anyways, some minis that I got, hot cocoa and cream body cream. They had the spray too, but I figured just the body cream and the shower gel would be easier for me to use up. And it smells really, really good. Just smells like straight up hot cocoa. I got a Sunset Glow shower gel. I figured this would be really yummy to use in the summertime. And I did not get behind the Sunset Glow train this year, but I feel like I should have because this smells really good. Honestly, that cherry smells so yummy. So anyways, I feel like I missed out on that, but I'm not about to go buy a full size because I have too much full size body care. So, and then the next thing is a full size body care item. It is Champagne Toast in the Fine Fragrance Mist. Of course, I did not need this, but I miss Champagne Toast. I used to have it in every form. I've used up many of them before, and yeah, this is the Fine Fragrance Mist from the spring line. I thought, how beautiful is this packaging? It's just stunning. I might put this in my spring use it up project around Valentine's Day, just because I feel like, how fitting is that? It's so pretty. So I was very happy to have this and to have Champagne Toast back in my collection because honestly, it just smells so good and juicy. I love it. So that is everything that I got for my first Bath & Body Works semi-annual sale order. If you want to stick around, I'm going to show you guys what I got from Victoria's Secret Pink as well. But if you don't, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys in the next video. So let's get into VS Pink. So we have a Victoria's Secret and a Victoria's Secret Pink in my mall. And I don't really care for Victoria's Secret that much, to be honest. I don't care for their mists. I don't care for their perfume. I'm really not a perfume person. I think I have like the scent palette of a 7-year-old. I like fruity things and I like things that smell like cookies. So that's like the only 2 things that I like. I don't like things that smell florally or like a grown woman, which I'm 23, I'm a grown woman, but I don't like smelling like that. So Victoria's Secret Pink is more down my alley. So the first thing that I went for in VS Pink, of course, was the body care. I picked up the Warm & Cozy Mini Body Mist. I've used Warm & Cozy before. I really love this scent. It's kind of like a coconutty vanilla. Yeah, that's basically what it is. And this was $4. All the minis were on sale for $4. Yeah, it just is like a very soft and sweet scent. And then I got the Honey Scrub, Honey Plus Sugar Nourishing Body Scrub, again for $4. I've never tried their scrubs before, so I didn't want to get like those huge pots that they have. So I got a mini one and I'll try it out and see if I like it. But yeah, I just wanted to give Victoria's Secret a try. I have not been in there since high school, so like 6 years ago. Yeah, so it's been a minute since I've been in there, so I just wanted to try out a few things. And then I got a 2 for $10 on the full size body mist. The first one is Whipped Dream. It says cake sprinkles and vanilla caramel. This one is just like a nice warm scent. And how can you not love that the, I don't know what I'm trying to say, that the sprayer in there looks like a straw. Isn't that the cutest thing? And there's like sprinkles on it. It smells so good and yummy. It just smells like Victoria's Secret, to be honest. And then Vanilla Swirl is the other one I got. It's frosted vanilla and sugar crystals. So pretty. It just smells like straight up sugar. Oh, it smells so good. So of course I didn't need any more body care or any more mist because I don't go through these very fast, but I bought them anyways because they're cute and they smelled great. So they smelled like sugar and so I bought them. And then I got a few clothing pieces. So everything was 50% off. I picked up this little cropped workout tee. Is this not the sweetest little thing you've ever seen? So these are kind of like those skin tight, like bodycon material that's good for when you work out. I got a medium. It was originally $39.95, so I got it for, wait, if it's originally 40, I got it for 20. There we go, $19.99, and it's a long sleeve. And it has thumb holes. Seriously, can you blame me for getting this? It's so cute. So even the lady that was shopping next to me, when I picked this up, she goes, oh my god, that's so cute, is there another one? And I was like, no, I'm sorry. And she goes, oh, that's gonna be so cute. And I was like, thanks. And then I picked up these leggings. They have pockets on them, and they were the only ones in the lineup of leggings that had pockets, so I immediately snatched them up. And they have like a mesh panel on the side. I don't know if you can see it, but yeah, I figured these would be really fun. And I need a new pair of long black leggings because mine have lost their elasticity because I've had them for too long. I just realized there's also a pocket on the inside here. I didn't even see that. How nice. Okay, so then these are originally 59, so they're originally 60 and I got them for 30. So yeah, I have not worn Victoria's Secret athletic wear in a minute too, but I remember it being really good. I used to have some pants from there in college and I remember them being really awesome. So yeah, I picked up a few of those things too, and that's everything from Victoria's Secret. I probably won't go back in there from Victoria's Secret Pink. I probably won't go back in there this year for SAS just because I don't need to spend any more money, but I did do an online order on the first day of VS Pink SAS, and I ordered like 6 or 7 pairs of underwear. I do that every time they have their sale. I order like a bulk set of underwear for myself. I just do that like every time. So twice a year, I just rebuy all of my underwear and I get rid of my old stuff. So that is it for me for this video. That's everything I got for both SAS at Victoria's Secret Pink and at Bath & Body Works. I will probably not be back to VS Pink, but I might go back to Bath & Body Works. I still wanna see if they have any other like body care minis and if I can find any more hand creams. I just wanna see, I'll probably go back to my outlet because they usually have like more unique stuff. And just see if they have anything else probably around the last week of SAS. But for now, that's everything. I definitely don't need any more soaps. I'm good on that. But yeah, I'm really happy with everything that I picked up. I really went in here going to kind of stock up so I wouldn't have to buy anything until next summer's SAS, which is what I usually do for SAS anyways. So that's it for this video. Let me know down below what you guys picked up at SAS. What are your favorite finds? I think my favorites are probably champagne toast at 75% off. That's like $3 for this. I really am glad that I found the lip glosses. I'm excited to try these. I don't know what they're like, so that'll be fun. And yeah, I think that's about it. So anyways, thanks so much for watching, guys, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.